Welcome to Beyond Just Money by Kalkine Media, an independent global media house and investor relations group. Please note that this podcast is for information purposes only. It's not a solicitation or recommendation to buy, sell, or hold the stocks of any company or companies or engage in any investment activity under discussion. Kalkine Media is neither licensed nor qualified to provide investment advice through this platform.
Welcome to Beyond Just Money with me, Samtha. And today with me, we have Nidhi, who is the head of content for Kalkine Media. And we will be discussing about the Justin Trudeau government passing the controversial C10 digital bill that seeks to regulate programming disseminated by media streaming and digital platforms like Netflix, Facebook, and YouTube. So Nidhi, what is your take on the recent C10 digital bill?
Thanks, Samtha. You're right, the C10 bill is a controversial one. However, even though the Trudeau government has passed the bill, it still requires passing the scrutiny of the Canadian Senate, where the incumbent government does not hold a majority. Hence, this may be a hard nut to crack for the Liberal government.
In fact, Nidhi, you know, these days, Netflix, YouTube, Facebook, or any other digital platform that we talk about is something that we are all glued to. So what does the bill mean for consumers like us?
That's a pertinent question. The bill does change the viewership experience of digital channels. A lot of critics, in fact, caution that the proposed law could be a violation of individual choice to watch content, almost akin to censorship. Online posts and content suggestions are mostly generated by algorithms that track the individual's content history and preference. So under the proposed law, viewers may be forced to watch what the government wants and not what they want. However, some claim this may put an end to the big tech's data collection moves that invade privacy.
Okay, and how are the digital content providers looking at it?
So the bill's suggestions for controlled programming currently in place for media outlets will impact all online ventures with moderate success. If the bill becomes a law, the US-based entertainment and tech companies such as Netflix, YouTube parent Alphabet, and Facebook will come under its purview. While the bill claims to promote and finance the distribution of more indigenous content, it would be a far-fetched approach as most digital and over-the-top or OTT platforms use a personal search algorithm to provide content recommendations. The proposed digital media bill aims to protect domestic cultural enterprises and targets new age media, primarily dominated by global online content distributors. Digital content creators and publishers believe such amendment to the existing Broadcasting Act can control personal expression on digital media and other online content networks.
Well, Nidhi, to conclude, can you take our listeners through the impact on the entertainment and live streaming service provider stocks?
Sure, Samtha. I'll quickly take you through the impact on the entertainment and live streaming service provider stocks on the back of the above development. Stocks of Netflix rebounded after showing a slight downward movement at market opening hour on Tuesday. The OTT platform's share price has gained 7% in 1 year, offset by the massive tech correction. Netflix has added an unprecedented number of paid subscribers from Canada during repeated periods of the recent lockdowns. In 2019, the company had a total of 14.6 million Canadian subscribers on its platform. Meanwhile, Alphabet stock was trading almost flat on Tuesday. The US-based tech company's share price has risen more than 67% in 1 year. It has surged as much as 39% year to date and has beaten the NASDAQ Composite Index, which was up 20%. Lastly, stocks of Facebook were up nearly 1%, but noted a downward trend on the back of the Canadian digital media bill. The social media stock has gained 22% year to date, which is up almost 2 times against the benchmark index.
Thank you so much, Nidhi, for discussing with us what the C10 digital bill really means for the digital content providers like Netflix and Facebook and YouTube.
Thank you, Samtha. I'm sure this bill will impact a lot of consumers like you and me.
Well, on that note, to listen to this podcast again, please log on to our website, that is kalkinemedia.com, or you could log on to our YouTube channel. Please don't forget to like, share, and subscribe, and hit that bell icon to get notifications on the latest videos and podcasts that we upload. Until we see you next with yet another insightful episode of Beyond Just Money, this is me, Samta, saying goodbye. And till we meet next, stay apprised and invest wise with Calkine.
Our listeners are requested to make their own inquiries about any investments, and Calkine Media strongly suggest that the listeners seek advice from a financial advisor, stockbroker, or other professional as necessary. Calkine Media hereby disclaims any and all the liabilities to any listener arising from any use of the information shared or discussed in this podcast. This podcast is available for personal and non-commercial use only.